We don't have time to moan about the architecture.
Thank you, dear. You remember where the shade is?
Down there, isn't it? No, please. It must be here.
Tantum has moved it. Now, that was childish.
We toppled his government. It's hardly surprising he wants revenge.
Pirates deserve defeat.
But he's trapped us. We're doomed. 10 floors up in a collapsing building. Great.
We can't simply stand around here and wait for this place to fall around us. Come on, Camille. This isn't over yet.
Down. We should head down.
No, Camille doesn't stay either. We're in just as much danger out there.
Now that looks promising. The stairway's through there.
At least there were stairs here.
Look, I reckon we could jump down to that platform there.
You might, my child, but I'm not sure I'd make it. I'm not as young as I once was.
You're only as young as you feel. I have faith in you.
What would I do without you, Miss Amy?
Though it might be worth making a move soon. This place doesn't feel secure.
Fingers crossed, eh? Oh! Ah, child's play. Your turn, Camille. It isn't as half as far as it looks.
Good job we went when we did. We're going to have to keep moving if the platforms are going to keep falling. Where's your walking stick?
Well, I must have left it in his office. Plenty more on the ship.
Take my hand. We'll be fine.
Of course you will. We always are. No more stairs. Ground floor.
Outside? Doctor, perhaps we should move away. The entire building is going to fall.
When it falls, it can only go in one direction. We just have to avoid that direction. Like cutting down a tree in the forest.
That's a really big tree, though.
The principle still stands. If my calculations are right, we'd better run faster.
Or squish?
Not quite how I put it, but yes, squish. Camille, can you hear me?
Oh, that was far too close for comfort. Doctor? I'm a little stuck. Could you lend a hand? And before you fret, I'm fine. Not hurt, no bones broken. Just trapped under some rubble. First time I've been trapped under a building, I'll say that. Safe at last.
Other than destabilizing the planet.
Way to ruin a move. So, plans for escape?
Already figured it out.
The TARDIS! It survived the building collapse! Tough old bird. Doctor, take a look up there. Up in the sky. Are those?
Escape craft. Didn't think the lucky stars would be.
There don't seem all that many of them. How many do you think there are?
Looks to me like maybe three rockets.
Only three? But their fleet! They had hundreds! How many survived?
We should leave. The planet doesn't have long.
You said they'd get away. How many did? Doctor, I'm not leaving until you answer me.
At best, 1,000.
1,000? Billions of people! 1,000 survived? You said they'd get away.
Is everything all right?
I'm tired.
You should rest. We could both do with it.
How long were we there, Doctor? A week? All those people we met on Photonics. all those people Taunt and oppressed. They're gone. Dead. Emelor. Shakir. Henry, his children. Quilt. That place. I wish you had never taken me there.
You know why we went. Potomix is a special planet, Camille. It is one of the few places in all of time and space where you can actually feel the planet rotating on its own axis. Remember how remarkable it was? How we laughed! We both fell over a few times getting used to it.
I know what you're trying to do, but too many people died. And what about all those people lost to the Xylons? And Rosie? You show me wonderful things, but all the marvels in the cosmos can't make up for the number of people I've seen die.
I cannot apologize enough. I thought I could make things better. I don't forget anyone I lose. They all stay with me. Even the people I greet as I walk past, doff my hat and smile at. I can't forget them, Camille. That's my fault for taking you there. It's my fault that so many people died. I should have saved more, even if only one.
It isn't your fault. I would never blame you. I just can't deal with this right now. It's too much for one day, you know? Take me somewhere we don't have to constantly deal with death, please, Doctor.
Do you want to go home?
No. No. I couldn't give this up, not quite yet. I know I'm not going to travel with you forever. One day I'll go home to my family and give acting another go, but not today.
My dear, I wouldn't want you to think you had to stay with me for any reason.
Well, I don't know what you'd do without me.
Neither do I.
I promised myself that if it ever got too much and I couldn't cope, I'd go home. I am still enjoying myself, and I do love the places we've been. I mean, how many people have walked inside the moon? And none of my friends had the chance to audition for Psycho.
I still think you were right for the part. But you know what Hitchcock was like.
Even after we saved his life. Twice. But what I'm trying to say is that I'm grateful. I look at the world in a different way now. I'm more appreciative of everything around me. It's just that these last few places we've visited, our last few adventures have been so much more intense and a lot more frightening than usual. And I'm sure you've seen worse. I can see it in your eyes. I'm sorry, Doctor. I know time travel isn't all fun and games. And I get that we help people when we can. I don't have a problem with that. But please, this time, can we go somewhere nobody needs saving?
My child, I truly must apologize. Let me make up for what happened on Potomix. No. I insist I make it up to you. In our relatively short time together, we have seen some unfortunate things. But I am going to make it my mission to put a smile on your face, Miss Ein. If you would be so kind as to press that button. Ah, very good.
I've picked up a thing or two. If I was stranded with the ship, I reckon I could get it to go.
I have no doubts about that. And with that...
Oh! Nice, bumpy landing. Go on, then. Tell me you've parked us somewhere lovely.
Well, I was trying for one of my favorite ice cream parlors, but that little jolt when we landed.
Though maybe we use the controls to figure out where we are first? Make sure we landed where you wanted us to, or at least somewhere they haven't invented the ray gun, or that isn't in the middle of a war over some glowing lantern. Sometimes I'd like to know what we're about to walk into. That's not asking too much, is it? You know, if it didn't sound so stupid, I'd be afraid that death was following us. Well, you. But that's ridiculous, isn't it? And you've already gone outside and didn't hear a word I said.
Of course, my child!
Thanks for agreeing with me.
Anytime. Are you coming outside?
I might wait a bit. Let you scout ahead and see what's what.
I won't be long. Just take a look around this corner.
You aren't going to wait for me or come back for me, are you?
Camille!
My impression is getting better. Well then, once more onto the breach. Wow. Wow, Doctor, you do take me to the best places. This can't be anything more than some side alley and a dingy one at that. It's all dirt and old bricks and yuck. Feels like the opening to some CSI thing. Doctor! Where are you?
Over here! Behind the ship!
What are you doing back there? Or do I not want to know? Yep, I was right. Didn't want to know.
Based on the blood splatter patterns, it looks like he was pretty close range. Point blank, bang.
Doctor, I could scream. I really could. I'm disappointed. Disappointed that this is happening.
We're all disappointed. He was my best lead.
Another new place, another person dead. I know how this works. It isn't like I'm going to be able to tear you and your curiosity away from this.
Rhodes, Detective Chief Inspector.
I'm the Doctor, and this is my partner, Camille.
We're equally ranked, me and him.
Well, I'm glad to have the assistance, if I'm honest.
Mr. Rhodes, mind if I have a quick word with my... partner?
By all means. I've got to call this in.
All right, usual questions. Who, what, when, where, why?
Well, he did introduce himself. Weren't you listening?
Fine, skip that one. And the what. I can see the dead body.
I'd say near the end of 1968. 1969.
The swinging 60s? Okay, that's not so bad then.
I don't imagine we'll see any of the swinging part of it, though.
Of course not. So, next question, where? Definitely England, you heard his accent. I assume you can tell me a rough region?
But is that concrete proof of where we are? People travel, you know. Well, you simply need to look at us.
Okay, if you don't know, we'll move on.
Why are we here? Why is this man dead? Why are we helping the police investigation? Why has he not questioned our identity? Why?
I get it. Lots of whys. He's coming back. Pick a place. You've only got seconds.
Are we playing a game?
Quick!
Right. Liverpool.
Manchester. We'll see who's closest. I have a question for you, Mr. Rhodes. You didn't bat an eyelid at me.
Oh, sorry. Did I hurt your ego? Was I supposed to compliment you or something?
My partner was merely asking why you didn't find her gender an issue. Not that she's complaining.
My partner happens to be female. I haven't been working with her for very long, but she's a good ally to have.
Behind every great man.
How flattering.
Just quoting Eurythmics. You know, I used to travel with Annie Lennox.
Not the time to name drop. Particularly not people from the future.
Behind every great man?
There has to be a great woman. Et voila.
We must be lucky, Doctor, to have found such excellent partners. Mine's been very useful in trying to crack this case. It was following one of her leads when I discovered this chap.
Do we know who he is?
We think the distributor and possibly the creator of Forget-Me-Not.
We're looking at a dead botanist?
I somehow doubt we're talking about Myosotis.
Myo-what?
Forget-Me-Nots. The plants.
What are you going on about plants for? Don't you know what a Forget-Me-Not is?
Another guessing game.
We should start wagering. I might make some money out of this. Oh, drugs! He said distributor.
Oh, well done, miss. Like everyone doesn't know that.
So, he's a drug dealer. That isn't quite what I was expecting.
Don't you find plenty of drug dealers these days, particularly here?
Yeah, why particularly here? What are you saying about Manchester?
How did you know that? You cheated, you must have.
Saw it on that board over there. Gotcha.
What are you two doing? You're prattling on like this is a playground, not a crime scene.
Mr. Rhodes, would you be so kind as to fill us in on Forget-Me-Not? We've been travelling, you see, assisting on many different cases. So much so that we haven't had a chance to look over any notes pertaining to this particular incident.
It's the new drug sweep in the nation. As if we needed another one.
But the 60s were full of drugs. Do we really have to stick around for this?
Oh, it's like nothing I've ever seen before. The user is sent into a brief, euphoric state. The impact is immediately felt.
Not exactly unusual. Must be highly addictive, then?
Particularly irresistible. And that's not the only reason why people use it. After the initial effects, it numbs the brain and meddles with memories.
So it helps you forget?
Sometimes. If it works properly. We thought it would depend on the strength and purity, but it doesn't work like that. It's unpredictable. It's like the drug is having mood swings, only working when it wants to.
So it doesn't always take memories away?
Look, sometimes it shuffles them around. Sometimes it adds, sometimes it alters. It can dig old memories up, it can bury recent ones. We think that's what the appeal is, the uncertainty of what'll happen next. but it's always got something really unpleasant up its sleeve.
You said it was addictive, but surely there's a chance that users will forget they've taken this forget-me-not.
We've only seen that with people who've lost everything. Those who can't remember a thing, someone takes it, has the moment of bliss, and then they get up with their brains all shook up and the persistent need for more. Whoever's selling this must be sitting on a small fortune.
Okay, that's very bad. Doctor, this shouldn't exist. I'd know about it if it ever did. This is another one of those let's save the world days, isn't it?
A truly terrifying concept. Being unable to tell what in your mind is reliable. I'm sorry, Camille, but I simply cannot turn my back on this. You're quite correct. This should not exist. Most certainly not here.
I know they've tried to hush it up. Nobody wants this kitten there, but you must have heard the rumours. This has been going on for ages, 10 months, and I'm barely any the wiser. My superiors have tried to take me off the case. They want better results, but no one else is getting anywhere either. Whoever it is out there, they are remarkably well hidden.
These mental mind wipe drugs, I should definitely know about this.
Maybe it's been wiped from your memory.
How do you know? We haven't had this conversation before and none of us can remember.
I try not to think like that.
Rhodes, would it be at all possible for me to take a look at a sample of this drug?
You better let him. You see, he's a revolutionary scientist. You only have to look at him to see that.
He'll have to be a genius. Our top scientists have been looking at it. They can't crack the mysteries behind the drug. What makes you think you can?
The difference between me and your scientists is that I know what I'm doing.
Well, I like your confidence, Doc. Right then, back to the office. Constable, secure the alleyway.
Everything all right, Doctor? You seem to be struggling.
Give me a second. I just need to reacquaint myself with how these old manual microscopes work. I'm so used to the automatic ones in my ship.
All a bit old-fashioned here, huh?
Yes, quite.
Old-fashioned? You are kidding.
Perhaps you'd prefer retro. Well then, shall we have a look under the microscope? Me first.
I used to love them when I was a kid. All those times looking at onion cells in a science lab, I really did used to love it. Anyway, so can you shed any light on forget-me-not?
I've only had a chance to make a cursory inspection due to my companion's curiosity.
Sorry!
But that is sufficient to prove to me that this is an alien substance.
An extraterrestrial drug.
Now, come on, be serious.
Do you think this is a subject suitable for humor? Let me assure you, Detective Chief Inspector Rhodes, that the molecular makeup of your forget-me-not does not match anything that has been found on Earth to this day and for many days yet to come.
You are being serious.
So why would an alien come to Earth to supply drugs? I mean, that's a little weird, isn't it? This would be a strange market for them, don't you think?
Ah, but think about it. You said it yourself. What is this world doing right now more than ever before?
I think experimenting is the most appropriate term.
Precisely. Where better than a world already eager to try new substances that could easily have some rather nasty side effects?
You are being serious. Hello, you're being serious. I'm really having real trouble with this one.
What if Earth is a giant laboratory for them to design the ultimate drug?
What if they came here, wherever they may be, test out the substance on human beings before taking it universal?
You mean like a trial run?
Quite the horrifying thought. And your theory is no more uplifting. We seem to have stumbled upon a terrible scheme, whichever way you look at it.
Oh, gosh. Doctor, it really is you. What are the odds of bumping into you? How absolutely fab.
Yes, very fortuitous.
Be gentle. He doesn't get hugged that often. No need to look so frightened, Doctor. It's a sign of affection.
Don't you recognize me?
I'm afraid I don't. And I have a very good memory when it comes to faces.
You have a good memory when it comes to just about anything besides how to fly the TARDIS properly.
The sad truth is that you have an advantage over me. You clearly know who I am, but I haven't the faintest clue who you might be.
Oh, Doctor. I'm Giovanna Everglade. Ring any bells? We've already met, about 5 years ago. You remember I helped you stop that lunatic from devastating the planet? Tell me, are you still traveling in that police box?
Of course I am. You know me, I can't help but love the look of it.
Hey, I suppose suppose it'll finally blend in with us being here. That'll make a change.
And who is this lovely lady?
This is my travelling companion, Miss Camille.
Nice to meet you.
If the greetings are done with, thank you.
Cat no longer got your tongue.
Look, I'm not saying I believe you.
If you don't mind my asking, what part do you play in these proceedings, Giovanna? You're not an officer.
That is true. I'm not. But I do have a special set of skills that make me quite the useful asset.
Can't you tell, Camille? She's psychic.
Ah, you remember.
Oh, well, I can feel you trying to poke about in my mind.
Sorry. I can't always control it. It won't do any harm.
Oh, now don't fret. I'm familiar with a gentle exploration of a budding telepath.
Psychic? Really?
Might I prove myself? With your permission, of course. Let me read your mind.
Fine.
Then think of something I couldn't guess. Think it loud, and that'll make it so much easier for me to focus in on it.
So you need me to help you?
If you guide me, I'll read what you want me to. Otherwise, I might unearth something you don't want me to know.
Okay, I'm screaming it in my mind.
You're telling Lord Byron to stop flirting with you. Because... What's a Zygon?
That's what you thought of.
You said we'd go visit Mary Shelley and beat her when she had the idea for Frankenstein. Instead, we ended up dealing with an injured shapeshifter wreaking havoc all over Renaissance Italy, with Mr. Mad, Bad, and Dangerous to Know knocking at my heels the entire time. It's the sort of thing you'd have to see to believe.
He said...
Perhaps the things he said aren't worth repeating.
He really said that to you?
I was thinking of some of the tamer things. That man was truly wild.
Doctor, where do you take your friends?
Somewhere new.
Never a dull moment. Psychics in the 60s. How typically you, Doctor?
I've met plenty of people with similar powers, even travel with some. Plenty of humans have telepathic powers. They just don't normally like to broadcast it.
And we're very glad Giovanna came with us. She's rather helpful, especially with the interrogations. She's much better than a lie detector. And a lot prettier, too. And she can access certain memories. Some things that people have forgotten. Not all the time. Sometimes we get people who have taken so much their brains have been barbecued.
I do what I can.
Phenomenally impressive. And good to see you using your powers for such benevolent purposes.
I can feel you now. After you reached into my mind, it was like you set up some sort of connection between us. I can still feel where you touched my memories. But I can also...
Oh, I almost forgot. Rhodes, they've got someone downstairs. He's ready to interrogate.
Yeah, whoa, 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 whoa. You mean we've got someone in custody? Someone actually important?
Hopefully.
Right, excuse me. Coming you.
Not so fast, Doctor. You're answering a few questions first.
I thought we were going to watch an interrogation, not be part of one. Is everything all right?
I had a glimpse into her mind. At least I think I did. It was an uncomfortable feeling. Fleeting, but I could have sworn I saw something. A feeling inside her mind.
Perhaps a little psychic feedback? Wouldn't take any notice of it. It'll go away soon. Nothing worse than a headache.
If you say so. Doctor, I don't think I trust her. It's like an instinct. I mean, you don't remember her, but you still trust her. That doesn't strike me as sensible.
Oh, that's simple. I haven't met her yet. Imagine I meet her in my future, but in her past. For her, it has already happened, but for me, it's a wonderful tomorrow. Sometimes you meet people in the wrong order. It gets annoying, but if I'm honest, you'll learn to live with it.
All right, Doctor, but I'm not entirely convinced by her.
Believe me, there is no need for concern.
I just have a bad feeling about her is all.
Well, you have me curious. What kind of bad feeling?
Oh, I don't know. Like the hairs on the back of your neck standing on end. All right, that sounds like nothing. Let's forget about it.
Ah, Doctor, Camille. We've just received confirmation that he's a user. It's still in his bloodstream. But also... We think he might have some links to the upper echelons of the drug ring that we've been looking for. This could be our guy. Our way in.
We're going to go in and talk to him. You can stay in here and watch.
I've always wanted to be on this side of the glass.
And what is that supposed to mean?
Interview commencing 11:13, DCI Rhodes and Miss Everglade in the room. Now, Mr. Warren, time for a little chat.
We already know quite a lot.
But there are a few blanks that you're going to fill.
Come on, we don't want to waste the entire day.
Look, you will cooperate. Better to do it now than muck me about.
I've seen him break stronger men than you.
Oh, I see. The silent type. Okay, we can work with that. That's no problem.
You talk. We'll be lenient. Keep your mouth shut and your bosses might be happier. That's what you're thinking.
But if you keep quiet, this will not end well for you.
It won't end well for me if I talk.
Ah, and so he speaks. Well, let's see what else he'll say.
Or not. How about a glass of water? That might help.
Miss Everglade leaving the room. Now, it's just us two together. How about we see what else we can figure out,
Look at that old-fashioned justice.
So very disappointing. Violence is not the answer.
Well, remember when we are. Today it might just be the answer. So then, are we going to hang around here forever? If they've got the dealer...
No, we can't leave yet.
I know, mega nasty alien drug to deal with. I just meant we'll soon get to the bottom of this. Then I propose some shopping. Retail therapy. That'll make me feel a little better.
Fancy a trip to the theater while we're here? I'm sure there's a brilliant version of Streetcar around here right now. Or could it be in a few months? How about some music? When did the Who perform here?
Perhaps we should intervene? Oh, you already are.
Okay. Still don't want to talk? Think you'll need that water.
11:17. Dr. John Smith entering. As you were, Rhodes.
Excuse me?
Hello. What's your name? He can hear me, can't he? I know sign language if necessary.
As much as I would love to see him sign the rest of this conversation, he can hear you. He's probably as surprised as I am.
I don't like to take the physical route when a verbal one will do.
All right. What's it called? Psychological?
No. Conversation. Hello. What is your name?
Warren. Named Warren.
Good to meet you, Warren. Would you object to a medical examination?
He's already had one.
Not from me. Hold out your arm.
Well, do as he says. Any reason why you're taking his pulse?
Just checking something. Perfectly normal. Skin feels human, too. One more thing.
What the chuffing, Nora? What are you doing?
Sonic screwdriver. The sonic waves scan the body and highlight anomalies. Could I just...
No. You can't have this back. Not yet. Could be dangerous.
Detective Rhodes, give it back. That is my possession. You're committing the act of theft. I even have a witness. Give it back.
Fine.
Thankfully, no damage done. And just as I had thought... You're human.
Oh, of course I'm human. What else would I be?
If I listed all the alternatives, we'd be here all day and all night. Would you like me to?
I wouldn't.
Rhodes, give me a few minutes alone with him, please.
All right. But you know where I'll be.
Much appreciated. 11:20, DCI Rhodes leaving. Well, go on then. Now, just us. I think it's time you told me what you know about alien intervention.
His
tactics are strange, to say the least.
You can't hear me laughing in there, can you?
Who do you work for? What species are they? What planet do they come from?
Does he think that'll genuinely work?
It's good to see him being straight to the point. I think he wants to be done with this.
Oh, not taking this very seriously, then?
It's my fault. He knows I want to get away. Quick question. If this guy has taken a mind-altering drug, how can you be sure he knows anything or can remember it?
No. He knows something. He has to know something.
11:22. Miss Everglade enters with water.
Only the best for our suspects.
Well, at least Giovanna will get proceedings back on track.
Oh? Bottled, then? Spring water?
What do you know about her? Where is she from? How long has she been with you?
Well, I can't remember. Not for certain, it's all a bit of a blur, you know. But I know I can trust her. I can trust her with my life. I mean, she's a good person, Camille. I know she is. I know she is. Yeah.
Well then, if both you and the doctor are willing to trust her, maybe she isn't that bad. Maybe my instincts were wrong.
Now, Warren, neither of us are going to hurt you. We only want to ask you a few questions and put a stop to this. How does that sound?
All right.
So, good cop works. Might be worth remembering, eh, Rhodes?
But only with her. I only trust her.
It seems you have an admirer.
Only her.
I guess that's my cue to leave. So, as long as you're happy with that.
Not a problem. I'll be fine. 11:24, Dr. John Smith leaves. See you later. Just me and you. Happy now?
Now that's what I call progress. Rhodes? Camille? They aren't here. Wherever have they got to?
Shall we get going?
I didn't mean to cause any problems.
No, but I'm interested. Like, where does Giovanna come from? I mean, there's so much I don't know about her.
But it should all be in her personnel file?
Yeah, in theory. Oh, here we are. They're all kept in here. Hang on. Aha! And here she is.
Go on, then. Take a look.
It feels wrong. Like I'm prying.
You're not looking for anything too personal. Nothing that a normal person wouldn't willingly share with a colleague.
I know, but...
What are you two doing here?
Filing.
So, no one's looking in on Giovanna.
Wait, and she's along with him. Stoned her.
She'll be fine, won't she? Just a quick peek.
Camille!
Maybe later. Coming!
I don't believe it. Giovanna's gone.
We'll get her back. We will find her.
What was that?
Look, someone's just taken a car. It's them. It has to be. He's taken her.
You heard him. Come on.
Rhodes!
Ah, he didn't even wait for us.
Typical. Well, I suggest we join in on the action. Screwdriver, please. Thank you.
What do you want it for?
It unlocks doors, doesn't it? If only it made popcorn, too. Come on, then, if you're coming. It's been a while since I've driven.
You do know what you're doing, right?
You know what they say, second time lucky.
That's the third time.
Good to know you have faith in me.
I don't want to be a backseat driver, but...
Normally, I'd appreciate that, but I don't know where I'm going.
Right.
Right?
I don't know. Wait, that car over there looks like Rhodes' car. Don't you think you're going a bit fast?
We're in the middle of a car chase. What do you expect?
Please, a little slower. Safety first.
I've got this. Can you see the one we're after? We've got to get to it. Save Giovanna.
Oh, that's a change of heart.
If I hadn't been so difficult, we might not be in this situation. So we're going to get her back, then I can go back to distrusting her.
That one there! That one's turning off!
No, that one there! Right ahead of us! Look, Rhodes is going after that other one. We'll stick with this one. We're catching up to it. What was that?
Looked like a pulse beam. Alien weaponry. I'm sorry, Camille. This isn't the holiday you wanted.
Time for some evasive driving.
Be careful! We're hit!
Ah!